since we're in Israel, we get very excited about kind of Israeli IPOs and everything else. How many Israeli companies are you expecting to IPO on NASDAQ this year?
Well, in 2013, we had 8, and that was higher than it's been recently. I predict, and it's only a prediction, and it could be good or bad, we'll probably do around the same number this year. And in the context of the size of the country and the number of IPOs we have in total, truly outstanding numbers. I mean, it truly is remarkable how many IPOs we receive from this relatively small country.
But Israel will still remain behind, obviously, the U.S., but also China. For a while, you think Israel's going to overtake China at some point soon?
Well, I think we had more Israeli IPOs come to NASDAQ last year than we had Chinese IPOs. But I'd say it's more important to look at one, besides the numbers, you know, the quality and the consistency of companies that are generating the entrepreneurship, the innovation coming out of this country is truly amazing.
How does NASDAQ view the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange? Friend, foe, potential target?
Well, I think there's ways for us to partner with each other. So I say we see ourselves as friends, and I think it's a 1+1 needs to get to a 3 type situation.
So the TAZ needs to become part of a bigger trading
organization? No, I said there's ways for us to partner together, and we're in discussions, and hopefully they lead to more fruitful advances with that. But clearly our job here is to make sure that companies have the ability to access the local market capital markets, and also have the ability to reach into the U.S. where it's appropriate for them.
One suggestion is that companies that abide by SEC regulations would perhaps automatically be allowed to trade on the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange, boosting the number of trading hours, boosting liquidity for both sides. Is that one thing that maybe
I think that has merit? It's not one we're talking about directly, but now that you mention it, I think something we'll pursue. So thank you.
Okay. Well, there's a lot of consolidation going on among bourses. NYSE, Euronext being bought by Intercontinental Exchange. There's what, some 13 exchanges and 50 venues for stocks in the U.S. now. Surely we're going to see more consolidation this year, and will NASDAQ be a part of that?
I think with respect to equity market consolidation, I think you'll see less of that than you're probably predicting there. NASDAQ obviously is always opportunistic. We've done a number of transactions over the years, but if you look at our past record, it's been about diversifying our business model, leveraging the strengths we have. So we're going to focus on continuing with that effort.
NASDAQ, very well known obviously as the home for technology stocks, but the biggest tech IPO of the year, Twitter, I guess perhaps after Facebook was last year, the biggest tech IPO of the year, you know, Twitter, went for NYSE. Does that worry you? Do you worry that's maybe a sign of things to come, that perhaps NASDAQ isn't now the natural home for the biggest tech companies looking to list?
Well, we are, and certainly we had a very good 2013, not a perfect 2013. Twitter's a great company, we wish them well, but we're proud of the success we've had. It's also important to recognize that NASDAQ has truly diversified its listing franchise. Our leading sector in 2013 was biotechnology, where we won about 98% of the listings that came to market. You also saw us break into what had been traditional strongholds of our competitors with consumers, with industrial. So we're very happy with, one, our progress in diversifying our listing venue, and also our success in tech.
There have been a couple of hiccups over the last couple of years with the flash crash, with Facebook IPO, with night trading. What lessons has NASDAQ drawn from these and is applying now perhaps as we move forward?
Well, for years we lived in a non-competitive monolithic world. In the U.S., in the U.S. in particular, we have this highly fragmented world where the infrastructure to tie all the players together is in a state of maturation. So I'm happy to say we've come a long way since the flash crash, but still, to have 60 venues coordinate among themselves in an integrated fashion, real-time, sometimes sub-second, takes some work.
After the August problems, NASDAQ, I think, said it was on the lookout for a new company to run its securities information processor, or SIP. Can you confirm that you are looking for a new company, and who would be in the running?
No, we didn't say that. What we were...
There was a Bloomberg report saying that you were looking for
okay.
That. Sorry.
So it gets detailed in terms of the SIP, right? Because we don't run the SIP. We're one of the many members of the SIP and the SIP governance. So that creates a certain, I think, baggage in terms of getting things done. Our concern is since the 22nd, we put forward 10 recommendations that had to be done to improve the SIP, and the SIP committee has not yet been able to come to a decision to move that forward. So we're concerned that we're running this SIP, but we don't control it, right? We can't say when it has to be fixed. When we say it has to, but we can't demand it gets fixed. We can only suggest it. So that's a problem.
Final question, because I know you do have to run. U.S. companies often complain about too much regulation, so that it's putting off companies from IPOing or coming to the U.S. In Israel, we have the same issue. I'm sure other countries also complain. I mean, where are we going here? Are we going to see more and more regulation, everyone just basically burdening companies with so much regulation that everyone's on a level playing field, or is it going to go the other way, that everyone's going to reduce regulation so we're competing?
Great question. I would say this. Certainly with respect to Sarbanes-Oxley, you saw most of the principles of Sarbanes-Oxley were copied by the developed markets around the world. Better or worse, not comment on good or bad. But in the U.S., the Jobs Act was the first bipartisan deregulatory action ever, and that's had a positive impact on the market. So hoping now, following Sarbanes-Oxley, other jurisdictions around the world will follow the lead of the Jobs Act, and it's a deregulatory action had a definite positive impact on IPOs in 2013.
Should MSCI Europe have included Israel in its European benchmark?
Yes.
Great.